welcome to another episode of Music in the Time of Crisis. As I was considering which piece to present, I found myself thinking about the artistic and musical world that existed at the time of the last big pandemic, the Spanish flu of 1918. And I suddenly remembered that Stravinsky's chamber theater masterpiece, The Soldier's Tale, was composed and premiered in Switzerland at exactly that time. When World War I broke out in 1914, Stravinsky and his family had already left their home in Ukraine, and they were taking refuge in the picturesque Swiss village of Clairin, where he had composed The Rite of Spring a couple of seasons before. The following year, they moved to the similarly idyllic village of Morges, and there they sat out the remaining years of the war, not to mention the Russian Revolution, which broke out a couple of years later in Stravinsky's hometown of St. Petersburg. During the war years, European orchestras and theater companies no longer had the resources to perform his massively orchestrated pre-war pieces and his ballet scores. And the royalties from his German and Russian publishers had completely dried up. And so, as he so often did during his long and amazingly peripatetic life, he made an artistic virtue out of necessity and started composing music for much more spare, intimately scaled ensembles. There in the village of Morges, his landlord was the Swiss conductor Ernest Ansermé, whom he knew from their days together at the Ballet Russe in Paris. And as it happened, Ansermé had recently returned from a tour of America where he had heard music and become fascinated by ragtime and jazz. And so he had brought back jazz band scores that he shared with Stravinsky, who became similarly intrigued by this strange, fresh, new style of music making. Ansermé also introduced Stravinsky to his friend, the writer Charles Ferdinand Rameau, and they hit it off. They decided that they would collaborate and create a small traveling theatrical musical troupe with which they could tour around in the rural villages of Switzerland. So Stravinsky introduced Rameau to a book of Russian folk tales, and they selected and transformed one of the stories into Histoire du Soldat, The Soldier's Tale, which they set for narrator, a dancer, two actors, and a seven-piece mixed ensemble of winds, strings, and percussion that Stravinsky modeled after the jazz band music that Ansermé had brought back with him from America. Stravinsky's musical score ingeniously combines old Russian folk styles with proto-Cubist parodies of popular dance music and American ragtime, and Rameau's story is a variation on the old Faust legend. A young soldier on leave from the war meets the devil on the road to his home village. The devil persuades the soldier to trade his fiddle, which is a stand-in for his soul, for a magical book that will infallibly predict the direction of the financial markets. And so they make the trade, and as the ultimate inside trader, the soldier now becomes more and more financially wealthy as he becomes more and more spiritually impoverished. Eventually, in a state of depression, he tricks the devil into playing him in a game of cards, where he deliberately loses back all of his ill-gotten gains, causing the devil to collapse. Soldier then reclaims his fiddle, he marries a beautiful princess, and prepares to live happily ever after. But then the devil wakes up, and he warns the soldier that he must never attempt to reclaim his former life by crossing the border back into his old village, under the penalty of losing everything that he has. And so his bride persuades him that it will be okay if he goes back just this once to fetch his aging mother, because then he will really have everything. And so he goes. And as he nears the outskirts of the old village, the devil is waiting for him. And the instant that he steps over the border, the devil rises up, reclaims his fiddle soul, and marches him off to hell. The moral is, be happy with what you've got, Don't be greedy. Don't try to have it all. The first performance of The Soldier's Tale took place at the main theater in Lausanne. And it was a stunning success. But then the Spanish flu swept into Switzerland like the devil himself, taking down most of the cast and the musicians, and the rest of the tour had to be canceled. And the next performance did not take place for several years after that. Does this sound a little familiar to you?